Hi, welcome to the WTAMU Virtual Math Lab. This video will step you through College Algebra Tutorial 23A, Example 4. In this example, we want to solve the quadratic inequality x squared minus 6x is greater than negative 2 by using the test point method, write our answer in interval notation, and graph the solution set. In step 1, we want to write the quadratic inequality in standard form. The standard form for a quadratic inequality is like the standard form for quadratic equations. Ax squared plus bx plus c, either less than or greater than 0. The reason we are doing this is 0 is our magic number. It is the only number that separates the negatives from the positives. If an expression is greater than 0, then there's no doubt that its sign is positive. Likewise, if it's less than 0, its sign is negative. We cannot say this about any other number. Since we are working with inequalities, this idea will come in handy. With this technique, we will be looking at the sign of a number to determine if it's a solution or not. It looks like we need to add 2 to both sides to get this in standard form. This will give us x squared minus 6x plus 2 is greater than negative 2 plus 2. This will simplify to be x squared minus 6x plus 2 is greater than 0. In step 2, we want to set up what we found in step 1 as a quadratic equation and solve it to get the boundary points. The boundary points will mark off where the quadratic expression is equal to 0. This is like the crossover point, since 0 is neither positive nor negative. Our equation will be x squared minus 6x plus 2 equals 0. This trinomial cannot factor, so we need to turn to the quadratic formula to solve this. Since this is a standard form, which is ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, this means that a equals 1, b equals a negative 6, and c equals 2. A reminder that the quadratic formula is x equals a negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Plugging in our values for a, b, and c, we get x equals a negative b, which will be a negative negative 6, plus or minus the square root of b squared, which will give us a negative 6 squared, minus 4 times a, which is 1, times c, which is 2, all over 2 times a, which is 1. This will simplify to be x equals 6 plus or minus the square root of 28 all over 2, which will simplify to be 6 plus or minus 2 square root of 7 all over 2. And when you divide both of those terms in the numerator by 2, you get 3 plus or minus the square root of 7. So it looks like we have two boundary points, 3 plus the square root of 7 and 3 minus the square root of 7. In step 3, we want to use the boundary points from step 2 to mark off test intervals on the number line. Here we have marked off our boundary points of 3 minus the square root of 7 and 3 plus the square root of 7. Note that we are using open holes at the two points because our original inequality did not include where it is equal to 0. Note that our boundary points mark off three sections on the graph. Negative infinity to 3 minus square root of 7, 3 minus square root of 7 to 3 plus square root of 7, and 3 plus square root of 7 to infinity. In step 4, we want to test a point in each test interval found in step 3 to see which interval or intervals are part of the solution set. When we do this, we can choose any point in an interval to represent that interval. Once we choose this value, we will plug it into the quadratic in standard form to see if the sign is either positive or negative. Keep in mind that the original inequality in standard form is x squared minus 6x plus 2 is greater than 0. To be greater than 0 means that the quadratic has to be positive. Let's go ahead and choose 0 from the first interval of negative infinity to 3 minus square root of 7 to plug into this. Plugging a 0 into the quadratic, we get 0 squared minus 6 times 0 plus 2, which is equal to 2. Since we got a positive number and we are looking for a positive, this interval is part of the solution. Let's go ahead and choose 1 from the second interval of 3 minus square root of 7 to 3 plus square root of 7 to plug into this. Plugging a 1 into the quadratic, we get 1 squared minus 6 times 1 plus 2, which simplifies to be a negative 3. Since we got a negative number and we're looking for a positive, this interval is not part of the solution. Let's go ahead and choose 6 from the third interval of 3 plus square root of 7 to infinity. Plugging a 6 into the quadratic, we get 6 squared minus 6 times 6 plus 2, which will simplify to be 2. Since we got a positive number and we are looking for a positive, this interval is part of the solution. In step 5, we need to write the solution set and graph this. Since we are not including where it's equal to 0, this will be an open interval and we will use curved ends to indicate this. So our final answer for the interval notation is the open interval of negative infinity to 3 minus square root of 7, union with the open interval of 3 plus square root of 7 to infinity. The graph will look like the interval notation. We'll have a curved end at 3 minus square root of 7 and shade everything to the left of that, and a curved end at 3 plus square root of 7 and shade everything to the right of that for our final answer for the graph.